TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Wednesday, the 11th of March. Government focusing on bringing back Indians from COVID-19 hit Italy, Iran says foreign minister. Activists lambast Pakistan Army for human rights violations against ethnic minorities. And Afghan President Ghani orders release of Taliban prisoners. And now for all the details. The government is focusing on bringing back Indians stranded in coronavirus hit Italy and Iran. After screening them, India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar said in the parliament on Wednesday. Meanwhile, with 10 more people confirmed positive for novel coronavirus, the total number of COVID-19 cases in India has jumped to 60 on Wednesday.
India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar said on Wednesday that situation in coronavirus hotspot Italy is now emerging as a cause of great concern. Speaking in the upper house of the parliament, Jaishankar said that the government is focusing on bringing back Indians stranded in coronavirus hit Italy and Iran after screening them. He said the government is ready to tackle the coronavirus challenge.
And our endeavor is to ensure the earliest possible return of our nationals after appropriate testing and screening. We are working with Iranian authorities to operate some limited commercial flights for facilitating early return of remaining Indians after testing them. Our embassy staff and the medical team are working round the clock under difficult conditions to ensure the objective of earliest possible return.
The statement came on a day when the number of confirmed cases of novel coronavirus in India rose to 60, with two fresh positive cases, one each in capital New Delhi and Rajasthan province. Out of the 60 cases, 36 are Indian citizens, while the remaining 16 are Italian tourists in India.
Activists from Balochistan, Sindh and Khyber Pakhtunkhwa raised concern over human rights violations by Pakistani army at the 43rd session of the United Nations Human Rights Council. The activists highlighted how thousands of people who dare to raise their voice for justice have become victims of kill and dump policy of Pakistan.
Activists from Balochistan, Sindh and Khyber Pakhtunkhwa have lambasted the Pakistan army for carrying out human rights violations against the ethnic minorities. Speaking at the 43rd session of the United Nations Human Rights Council or UNHRC, Qambar Malik Baloch, a human rights activist from Balochistan, said that thousands of activists from his province who dare to raise their voice for justice have become victims of kill and dump policy of the Pakistani state, while the whereabouts of many others remain unknown.
Thousands of the Baloch political activists are being illegally detained in Iranian and Pakistani prisons. The whereabouts of thousands of forcibly disappeared persons are not known. Thousands have been the victim of the kill and dump policy of the Pakistani state.
Meanwhile, Dua Naz Kalhoro, a Sindhi political activist, also blamed Pakistan and its army for human rights violations against people in the Sindh province. She said thousands of acres of agricultural land in the province has been taken away by the Pakistani army in the last few years as part of the designs to convert Sindhis into a minority in their own motherland.
We want to draw the council's attention to our deep concern about illegal grabbing of hundreds and thousands of acres of land of indigenous Sindhi people in Pakistan. Bharia Town, a residential scheme, is just one example where the Supreme Court found the acquisition of over 22,000 acres of land illegal.
Human rights activists and residents of Balochistan, Sindh and Pashtun-dominated Khyber Pakhtunkhwa blame Islamabad has consistently maintained its oppressive attitude towards people of their respective regions and has even ignored their basic demands.
Afghan President Ashraf Ghani signed a decree to release Taliban prisoners to pave the way to talks between the Taliban and government. Ghani's prisoner swap would roll out over 15 days as the talks get underway. Afghan President Ashraf Ghani signed an order on Tuesday night to pardon and release Taliban prisoners in order for the peace talks between Afghanistan's government and the Taliban to start. According to the decree released to the media on Wednesday, the prisoners that will be released are required to make a written commitment not to return to the war. The process of releasing 1,500 Taliban fighters will be started on March 14th at Parwan prisons. This prisoner swap was the most contentious part of the US-Taliban peace deal signed last month and one that Ghani had rejected last week. The United Nations has backed the push to end war, but at Tuesday's Security Council meeting, the US warned the Taliban to keep its promises.
We acknowledge the Taliban have taken steps to stop attacks in cities and against major bases. But more needs to be done, and we urge them to also reduce violence against Afghan forces in the countryside to give intra-Afghan negotiations and peace the opportunity to succeed. Violence at these levels risks drawing both sides into a vicious cycle, serves no one, and undermines peace.
Afghan President Ghani's prisoner swap is supposed to help pave the way for talks with the Taliban and would roll out over 15 days as the talks get underway. But a dispute over who leads the Afghan government may complicate the process. While Ghani was sworn in for a second term on Monday, his political rival, former chief executive Abdullah Abdullah, says he's the country's rightful leader. He held his own Palra inauguration separated only by a wall. Nepal's flag carrier Nepal Airlines has announced suspension of flights to and from Qatar's capital Doha city amid coronavirus outbreak in the Gulf nation. The announcement comes days after Qatar suspended entry of 14 nationalities, including Nepal, as precautionary measure to contain the spread of COVID-19.
Nepal's flag carrier Nepal Airlines has announced suspension of flights to and from Qatar's capital Doha city owing to coronavirus outbreak in the Gulf nation. Issuing a press release, the national flag carrier has announced the suspension to be temporary, coming to effect from March 10, 2020. The statement also informed that the passengers who have already bought tickets to or from Doha can refund tickets without paying any extra charges. Nepal Airlines had flights to Qatar's capital Doha on a daily basis. The announcement comes a day after Qatar suspended entry of 14 nationalities into the country, including Nepal, as precautionary measure to contain the spread of COVID-19.
A Bangladeshi court has directed the government to take immediate measures to stop sudden price hike on sanitizer, hand wash and face masks amid fear of spread of COVID-19 in the country. Bangladesh has confirmed 3 COVID-19 cases so far.
A High Court Division bench in Bangladeshi capital Dhaka has directed the authorities to take immediate measures to stop price hike of sanitizers, hand wash and face mask amid fears of spread of coronavirus or COVID-19. The court directives came as an unusual hike was witnessed in prices of these items as people rushed to panic buy them a day after the government confirmed the first 3 coronavirus cases in the country on Sunday. The 3 patients include 2 Bangladeshi returnees from Italy, while one is their family member in Dhaka. The High Court bench also directed the government to take measures to set up adequate thermal scanners at all entry points of the country and issue health clearance certificates to people wishing to return home from abroad. Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina had earlier on Sunday urged people not to panic and assured that her government was prepared to tackle the virus.
Authorities in India's Jammu and Kashmir have started a beautification drive for the world-famous houseboats in the region with an aim to give a fresh impetus to the tourism sector. In a bid to increase tourism potential in Srinagar, the summer capital of India's Jammu and Kashmir, Local authorities have initiated a beautification drive for famous houseboats in the region. Under the beautification process, the houseboats are being painted in same colours, which officials believe will enhance the beauty of the boats along with the Jhelum River in Srinagar, making it the talk of the town.
Project liya hai Jhelum River mein 102 jo houseboats hain, ek to inka improvement ka jaise color code wagera ka hai, iske alawa jitne bhi families hain unko hum support extend karne ja rahe hain, un bachon ke education ke liye, tourism mein training ke liye, unke skill development ke.
The tourism players of the Kashmir Valley have also welcomed and appreciated the move, which they say will definitely help in boosting their businesses.
Main bahut shukr guzar hoon DCOM sahab ka aur DC sahab ka shukr guzar hoon jinhone ye step uthaya, bahut achhi step uthaya, isse bahut farak padega hamare house boat. Aaj tak kisi ne hame color valor nahi diya hai, to main DCOM sahab ka aur DC sahab ka hum house boat wale bahut shukr guzar hain.
Tourism is one of the main sources of income for locals in Srinagar. The industry faced downfall in August last year after the government scrapped the region's special status and restricted the entry of tourists for few days for safety reasons. The government is now trying to boost the tourism by attracting more and more tourists to Kashmir, which is often called the paradise on earth by visitors. Sikh devotees marked the annual festival of Hola Mohalla on Tuesday with a display of horse riding and traditional martial art in India's northern Anandpur Sahib city. The festival celebrates the bravery of ancient Sikh warriors.
Thousands of people gathered at Takht Shri Kesgarh Sahib, a famous Sikh shrine in India's northern Anandpur Sahib city, to witness ancient Sikh warfare Gatka in a ceremony to mark the annual festival of Hola Mohalla on Tuesday. The main attraction of the festival, which coincides with Holi, the Hindu festival of colors, was a display of horse riding, sword fighting and martial arts by Sikh warrior order Nihangs. The festival commemorates the transformation of the Sikh community into a martial fraternity by Guru Gobind Singh, the 10th spiritual leader of Sikhs. Meanwhile, devotees also offered prayers and took holy dip on the occasion at the Golden Temple, the holiest shrine of Sikhism in Amritsar city of northern Punjab province.
We came over here to get the blessings of the Almighty. We did have a dip in the holy water, and some people celebrate Hola Mohalla by going to Anandpur Sahib. They perform in various stuff like Gatka and stuff, but we just came here to get the blessings of the Almighty. That's how we, as a family, we celebrate this festival.
Sikhs make up about 2% of India's over 1.2 billion population, but they have a majority in Punjab and a sizable population in capital New Delhi.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Government focusing on bringing back Indians from COVID-19 hit Italy, Iran, says Foreign Minister. Activists lambast Pakistan Army for human rights violations against ethnic minorities. And Afghan President Ghani orders release of Taliban prisoners. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. It's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.